Hello, this is Michael again. Today is November 23rd, 2014. Today I will show you what a home theater PC is and how to connect it to a television. You can turn any older PC into a home theater PC. Like this one, an old HP, a Pentium, and there was once running Windows XP on it. When you look at the back of this PC, you see it's old. It even has a parallel port still. So what you need for a home theater PC is an HDMI port. This one does not have an HDMI port. And the solution, just add another graphics card, like this one here. This one has an HDMI port, 1 GB of DDR RAM, and it's a pretty good graphics card. And you can buy it for maybe $30. You see here in the middle, that's the HDMI port. With that port, you connect your PC to your TV. Of course, provided your TV has an HDMI port input, okay? So, I opened the case of this old computer. As you can see, everything looks nice and clean. So, it works. So, why not using it as a home theater system? And the graphics card you have to add here in this slot. Alright, I have already put the graphics card in. Now you just have to push it down. Ah, you heard this? A nice click. That means it is now firmly seated. And also take care that this little nose here has snapped in. And now the graphics card is in place. And this is now how it looks at the back. This is the expansion card. And here is the HDMI port. Very important. And another thing you will see here. Here is the slot for the hard drive. Here is no hard drive. Yeah, this here is a SATA cable. You have to put in a SATA hard drive. And I suggest to start with a 2 TB hard drive as a bootable drive. Please be aware, those older computers can only use up to 2 TB of a hard drive to boot from. That's it. Please don't buy anything bigger. 2 TB. That's it. As a second hard drive, knock yourself out, buy a 4 TB, buy a 6 TB hard drive. And down here, you see the memory slots, the RAM. Right now it has 1 GB of RAM. That's not enough. You should upgrade to at least 4 GB of RAM. And please be aware, the Windows 32-bit versions only can address up to 4 GB of RAM. Only the 64-bit version of Windows can address more than 4 GB of RAM, okay? But 4 GB of RAM is just enough for a home theater PC. And here you see the back of my Samsung plasma TV. I made some videos already about it. And you have to plug in the media center PC, your home theater PC, into the HDMI port. Here is one. This TV has in total 2 HDMI inputs. So you have to plug in the PC into that port. So the whole thing of plugging in is pretty easy. Yeah, you just take the cable and plug it in nice and snug. And now you take the other side, here it is, and you plug it into the HDMI on the TV. All right. All right, it's in. We made it. You see, that's the connection between PC and your television. And this is now the end result. As you can see, the Windows 8.1 desktop on my 60-inch Samsung plasma display. Yeah, and the resolution is very good when you use HDMI. HDMI is not only transporting the video information, it also transports the audio information. And here you see the desktop of my XBMC media center software. Yeah, it looks very good, very stylish. On top you see the last 5 movies I have put on the hard drive of my home theater PC. And here is a different look at my library. You see all the DVD covers are displayed. It looks very nice, looks very professional, and of course all those movies are in the original quality, not compressed like many other people do it. I have the full resolution. That's the reason I need so much hard drive space, because those movies are big, they are huge. And some other thoughts about a home theater PC. Yeah, you need lots of hard drive space, 2 terabytes minimum. And here is the DVD drive. You should maybe, instead of using a DVD drive, put in a Blu-ray drive. Just a reader or maybe also a writer. And these drives, just a reader, cost maybe $60-$70 tops. Yeah, and a writer without software $80, with software maybe $90 to $100. Yeah, it's really worth investment so that you can watch also Blu-ray discs on your home media center. I'm using my media center mostly for watching movies. Yeah, I'm copying the movies over and store them all on the hard drive, and it works wonderful. Alright, so any questions, please feel free to contact me. I will answer all your questions. I know this video only scratches the surface. Oh yeah, if you like to know, I'm using XBMC version 12 as my home theater system. There is also available Plex. It just depends what your needs are. Plex is more for people who would like to stream their videos to other devices. XBMC is supporting Blu-ray and DVDs very well, and in the future XBMC will be called Kodi from version 14 on. Alright, well, that's it for today. This is Michael. Please stay in touch, and my next video will come soon. Alright, again, please stay tuned for my next video.